So in the last class we got the expression for the DC side voltage, the instantaneous DC side voltage for one interval, that is two sub intervals. So we also got the expression for the average value of the DC side voltage and how the voltage on the DC side has an average value which is related to the one which used to be there in the case of zero inductance. So we got some equations. So now let us see the harmonics that are present in the DC side voltage. So the RMS value of hth order harmonic component Vd. So, Vd is the instantaneous DC voltage. So, if I take the hth order harmonic component, I mean the RMS value is denoted by V with a subscript h. So, this has two expressions because for some values of h it is 0. So, I will give the expression, I will leave it to you to derive. So, it is just an application of the Fourier series. So, the expression whenever it is not 0 is given by VDO into cos squared h minus 1 into u by 2 plus cos squared h plus 1 into u by 2. So, actually the first term is divided by h minus 1 whole square, the second term is divided by h plus 1 whole square minus 2 cos h plus 1 u by 2 cos h minus 1 u by 2 cos 2 alpha plus u. This is divided by h square minus 1. So, this entire expression is divided by 2 and this is taken under root. So, this is raised to half. So, this is VDO into cos squared h minus 1 u by 2 by h minus 1 whole square plus cos squared h plus 1 u by 2 by h plus 1 whole square minus 2 cos h plus 1 u by 2 cos h minus 1 u by 2 plus into cos 2 alpha plus u by h square minus 1. So, this is the expression for V h whenever it is non-zero. So, it is non-zero for h equal to, so what, for what values of h it is non-zero? 6 into any positive integer 6k. So, it is non-zero for all values of the type 6k where k is 1, 2, so on, and it is 0 otherwise. So, this is the expression for the hth order RMS component RMS value. So, I mean I will leave it to you to derive this, I mean it is just application of Fourier series.